So speak ye, and so do, as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty.
So the warning to Christians is, he says, if you have bitter envying and strife in your hearts, glory not, lie not against the truth. Somebody that's given to fights, that's given to strife, that's given to contention, they're going to lie. Here's the way. He says, glory not. What's the lying Christian want to do? They want strife, they want that fight. They're going to end up saying something that's not true. And then they won't back down from it. They won't correct the problem. Then they'll make it worse. This wisdom descendeth not from above, but is earthly, sensual, devilish. Used by the devil. Just like King Saul. He was saved. We will see him in heaven. And yet he was operating in a bad spirit. A bad spirit, an evil spirit was troubling him. He was prophesying of evil to the people around him. He tried to kill David, his friend. He wanted to throw him under the bus. He wanted to kill him. He wanted to see him gone. And David, being the man of God, full of the Holy Spirit as he was supposed to, he's just dodging spears, saying, I won't lift my hand against God's anointed. Well, I'm not going to go pick a fight. I'm going to leave off the contention and the strife. And as Christians, this is something we need to learn from. When you see somebody with this King Saul complex, be warned. That's contentious, that's strife. Stay away from it. He says it's earthly, sensual, devilish. And what's the cause? Once the devil gets in your ear and in your heart, what happens? Look at the next verse, verse 16. For where envying and strife is, there is confusion and every evil work. These other churches that have a problem with this, with the strife, with the envying, with the bitterness in their heart, he says there's confusion and every evil work. Why is it when you see the churches that we see in Revelation, why is it certain churches were allowing such wicked and evil things? Because of the strife, because of the contention, because they were earthly, sensual, devilish. They were walking as men, not walking with God. They were not walking in the Spirit. You know, I've spoken about J. Frank Norris before. And I took some flack, some people criticized me. Well, he was a Baptist. He's part of your lineage. Well, no, he's not. I didn't get saved by him, and I don't claim him for more than one reason. J. Frank Norris was an angry man. He was famous for killing a man in the church. He's famous for being accused of arson multiple times. And everybody, he wasn't known for being pro-Jesus. He was known for being anti-Catholic. Well, I can understand why you would want to be anti-Catholic, but I don't want it to be written on my tombstone, I'm anti-anything. I want it to be written that I am pro-Jesus, pro-gospel, pro-local congregation, pro-King James Bible, fill in the blank. But J. Frank Norris had a different spirit. He literally killed a man. They've accused him of murder. He ended up winning the case. He was accused of arson. There was evidence against him. He got out of that one too. But you know, the biggest thing about J. Frank Norris was that he openly supported a satanic secret society called the Ku Klux Klan. J. Frank Norris opened his doors and twice weekly provided furnishings, a room for the Ku Klux Klan to meet within the halls of his church. The Ku Klux Klan orchestrated these benefits for J. Frank Norris. They would stop the service. They would come in all of their garb with their hats and their masks, holding roses, giving a sacrifice to J. Frank Norris. As he's about to preach, he would just stop and let them come on down and let them do their thing. And they would honor him in front of his thousands of people in his mega church. Look, his heart was wrong. He allowed a satanic secret society in the church. He supported them, and then he allowed them to come to his church. Let me read this. The Ku Klux Klan's Masonic origins. It was founded in Pulaski, Tennessee in 1866 by six Confederate officers. One of them, and the first imperial wizard of the KKK, was a former Confederate general and Freemason, Nathan Bedford Forrest. Albert Pike held the office of Chief Justice of the KKK while he was simultaneously Sovereign Grand Commander of the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry. Albert Pike worships the devil. He was a wicked person. And then here you are, just 20, 30 years later, 40 years later, and guess what? He said, well, come on into the church. You can come into my church. You can meet here on Thursdays. You can bring in flowers to me. We'll stop the service and let you do your wicked. Listen, it's wrong to be a white supremacist. It is wrong to be a racist. God has made all the nations of one blood. They bleed red. There's only one type of race. It's the human race. Right. We are all humankind. Don't take pride in what country you came from or who your forefathers were. J. Frank Norris allowed a Luciferian secret society to come into his Baptist church because they honored him, because it was beneficial to him. Was he part of it? Did he put on a robe and a hat? Was he a Freemason? I don't know. But why would you let such Satanism in your church? Why? Because of his pride and because he would not let off contention. He was always looking for a fight. Look at this verse again, James 3:16. For where envying and strife is, there is confusion and every evil work. If J. Frank Norris had the right gospel and if he was actually saved, because of his own pride and because he just loved to get in the news for picking a fight, it says there was confusion and every evil work in his church because of that. That's the result. That's the result of pride. That's the result of picking fights all the time. Confusion and evil work. Boy, and if the Freemasons and the KKK isn't evil work inside of a church, I mean, how much more wicked can you get? That's why I don't honor J. Frank Norris. That's why I don't say, well, he's one of my Baptist forefathers. No, no, thank you. I'll claim the Lord Jesus Christ. Hey, I'll go back to John the Baptist, right? We'll go back to that church in the wilderness. But I don't count him in my lineage.
So speak ye, and so do, as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty.